What's up Mariners, this is Abhilash Thakur and welcome to Sailor's Guide. Alright guys, so as you all know that your liveboat is as good as your equipments. So your equipments should be as per the SOLAS convention and LSA code, SOLAS chapter 3. So I will try to show you all the equipments, what are all inside in the liveboat by using my liveboat. So let's jump into the liveboat without wasting any time. Okay guys, so now you can see here that I have a food tank and the freshwater tank here. Also you can see the inventory tag there where we have all the equipments inside. So let's open it up and I'll show you all the equipments which are inside and how much the equipment should be inside as per the SOLAS convention. So let's open it up. Alright guys, so here you can see we have kept some of the water also here because there is no space left here inside. Okay, so let's start with the food first. So for every person in the lifeboat, it's a 31 person lifeboat here, and for each person you should have a 10,000 kilojoule of food for every person. So now you must be wondering that how are you going to calculate the 10,000 kilojoule of the food. So don't worry about it. Here you can see the packets here. This is kind of a food which we have for the lifeboats. And you can see here that for one packet this is 10,000 kilojoule. Okay. So the manufacturer makes sure that for the one box it is 10,000 kilojoule. So you always check the total energy here. And as it is 10,000 kilojoules, so it means you must have 31 of them so that it covers the SOLAS convention. So as I have counted them yesterday only, so I'm not going to do it again because I have to rearrange it otherwise. So here you can see the vacuum seal is on every packet here. Vacuum seal is on each packet here. You also check this one, okay? And let's put it inside. Alright, so now we are going to start with another equipments. Okay, so here you can see there is one box here, 7 oceans, and they have 30 units in one box. Okay, one like this packets, it has 30 packets inside, and this packet is of 0.5 liters, it's half a liter, and you must have 3 liters of water for each person. This is 31 person lifeboat, so it means you must have 93 liters of water all the time, and this water is has expiry date, and it should be within the expiry date. Here you can see it is 2/6/2026, so it is all good. As I am making this video in 2021, so still we have 5 years to go. Okay, so in some ships you can see that there will be a cans and you have to fill up the water, fresh water. Every week you have to replace the water, so that is also one way, and this way is I think is better because otherwise you don't forget to replace the water weekly. So in this way you can just replace the water when it gets expires, and that's all. Here is the pyrotechnic box for the lifeboat. As per the SOLAS code or LSA code, we should have 6 hand flares, 4 rocket parachute and 2 smoke points in a lifeboat. Each lifeboat. Okay, so let's open it up. You need to check the expiry dates of all of these pyrotechnics, and it should be as per the code. So this is a rocket parachute, you can see here the long one. Here is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 4 rocket parachute. There's a small one here. These are the hand flares. Okay, so it should be 6 of them. So you can see here it's all 6 here. And these are the smoke point. Should be 2 in number, so you can see here. And you need to check all the expiry dates of all these pyrotechnics. It's very important. It should be within the range of the expiry date. Here you can see it's 9/24, 9th month of 2024. So it is valid for about 3 years. Check another one also. also. Yeah, the same date. Here you can see the hand flares. It's 8/24, so August 2024. All of them need to be checked. Usually it comes in the pair only, but still you need to check all of them. Okay, it's 824 824 824. This is 824 824, and this one, all of them are valid for another 3 years. Let's check the parachutes. You can see here the date of expiry is 9/24. For all of them it is 9/24. Okay, so numbers as per the LSA code, and also they are not expired, so it's all good. So let's put them back inside the box. Okay, let's put this container back inside. Okay, so let's keep it aside and check another equipment. Here you can see a tool kit here. As per the NSA code, you must have one tool kit for engine repair. The minimum equipment should be inside. Here you can see all the tools for minor engine repairs. Okay, let's pull out another bucket. Okay, as per the code also there should be two buckets. We have two buckets and I have kept all the equipments inside them. So let's pull it out. Here you can see the yellow bags. Okay, the yellow bags you can see here are the TPAs. The TPAs are thermal protective aid. They are used to keep a person warm. If you have recovered a person from the water, so you need to put him here inside this bag. It's just like a sleeping bag only. You see, here is some demonstration given here. Only the mouth area will be out, other than all the body will be covered up with this bag. So this bag provides heat to the person who has been recovered from the water, or a person who is feeling cold. Okay, so it should be 10% of the lifeboat capacity. So we have a 31%, so it's 3.1. 10% of 31 is 3.1, so we should have 4, because it is more than 3. So you see here we have 4. Okay, and we should have one point baler. This is the point baler. Point means it doesn't get sink, and it should be connected with the lanyard. Lanyard simply means a small rope which should be connected with it. Okay, done. Let's check the another bucket which we have. Okay, here we have a first aid kit. It should be, as per the SOLAS convention, should be one. We should have one first aid kit, and it is valid up to 5/23. You can see here it is valid up to 2 years. All right, we have a fishing tackle. Okay, everything is inside. Yeah, so we have a seasickness tablet here. So seasickness tablets should be enough for 48 hours for single person. So it's as per the dose. Here you can see that it should be given 3 times a day. So it means for 48 hours it should be 6 of them for a single person. So it's 31 person lifeboat, so it should be 186 tablets should be present. So here you can see we have must have 185 tablets of it. So here the 30 tablets in one box here you can see. So it should be 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So it means we have 210, which is more than sufficient. And here you can see the bags. They are the seasickness bags. Okay, seasickness bags should be 31, one for each person. Okay, so I have already counted it yesterday only. So there are 31 bags inside. Here you can see the can opener. It should be 3 can openers as per the SOLAS convention in the lifeboat. So we have 3 can openers here. Okay, let's see what is inside. So these all things should be in a waterproof packaging. Okay, so that's why we have a bag which can be sealed from above. Here we can see a survival instruction manual should be there. a signaling card, what signals to be given for help. Here you can see the jackknife here and a whistle. Okay, a knife and a whistle. Our knife also should be connected with the lanyard. You can see here, lanyard is simply, as I've explained earlier, the rope, and this is also a whistle. This should be in good condition. Here we have another packet here, in which we have all the manuals regarding the lifeboat, and also the maintenance manual, and also the engine manual is inside this. Okay, in case if you require, this is a dipper. A dipper with lanyard, okay. Lanyard you can see here. Here you can see a torchlight. Okay. Spare batteries are here. You can see. And one matchbox. Okay, here we have a measuring cup. Okay. These all things used for the water, okay, so that you can measure in with the cup, and you can give it to the casualties or to the people who are inside the lifeboats. Here you can see one more thing. This is called heliograph, which is also known as the day signal mirror. This is called as mirror. How to use it? So all the instructions has been given, so that you can pass the signal to the ship in the daylight by using the sun rays, and using this mirror, you can give this reflections to the ships to attract the attention of another ship. This is the same card for the life-saving signals. Okay, here you can see inside there are two rescue coats. You can see here, which should be connected with the line of at least 30 meters. This is the rescue coats to rescue the people who are in the water. So if you throw it into the water, a person can just put it into his arm, and you can pull that person to the lifeboat. Okay, he's just like a small life buoy. So it should be two of them. You can see here, there are the steps to come inside the boat. The steps to come inside the lifeboat, and here you can see this thing is called as radar reflector. Going to pull it out. It's in good condition. I've already tested it. So this should be in every lifeboat. This should be placed outside the lifeboat so that the radar of the another ship's marine radars can detect you from far away. So we have finished all the inventory which is inside. So let's move out to this things which we have outside this box. Here you can see a rainwater collector we have hanged here. It is the like a canvas only where you can collect the rain water and use that water for drinking. Here you have I was cleaning the lifeboat, sorry for this mop and the bucket. I was cleaning the lifeboat, and here you can see it is the sea anchor, okay, with everything inside. I'm not going to open it because it's going to create a mess otherwise. So this is the searchlight here. So also we should have oars. The coal, which is called as chappu in Hindi. Here four oars, two here. Okay, two boat hooks here. You can see on the top. You can see here two boat hooks. One is that, and one is that. Okay. So also for the oars, you must have the crutches, which you can see the U shape. These are known as the crutches, which you have to put outside the lifeboat. There is a space. I'll show you that one also. Here is the space, you have to put it here. Okay, and you have to put the oars like this so that you can move the lifeboat when you are not using the engines, so that you can save the fuel. Okay, it should be four of them, two on this side. Yeah, the crutches should be, everything should be attached to the boat. This is very important. This should be attached to the boat. Okay. Another thing you should have is this bilge pump. Okay, this is a thing you must have, and also two painters. So the one painter should should be attached to the arrangement which can be released from inside. The arrangement is here. You can see here the knob, which is in the red color. You have to pull it, and the painter, which is in the forward, can be released. Okay, I'll show you the painters which are outside of the live board. I have to go out and show you. This is the forward painter which we have, which can be released from inside, which I showed you the red knob. As soon as you pull the red knob, this knob, you can see here, it will turn up and it will come out. Okay, so you can release the painter from inside. Another painter you can see there, the white rope, which you can see, this one. You have to make fast this rope to the aft section of the boat. Here is the thing where you have to make fast on the red one. Okay guys, there should be one extinguisher also as per the IMO regulations. So here we have one DCP extinguisher for 6 kgs. Okay. Also guys, you remember to keep one just inventory inside the lifeboat. There should be all the equipments here, how many numbers, okay, and the expiry dates. So the equipments which can get expired, you put the expiry dates here, so it is easier to check for the people who are coming next. And also you mentioned here how, when is going to have the next service, this and that, everything is here. Okay, so let's put all of this back and I'll see you in my cabin. Alright guys, so this was all about the lifeboat equipments. If you find this video helpful, please press the like button and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get all the notifications of my videos coming in future. So if you have any doubts regarding the Merchant Navy or you have any questions regarding it, you can put in the comment box and I can try to make a video on it. Until next time, this is Abhilash Thakur signing off.